Dragon's Dogma 2 is finally here, and it's the first massive open-world game from Capcom to utilize the newest iteration of the RE engine. And even with its large open-world size, Dragon's Dogma 2 retains most of the visual features seen in previous RE engine games, like the highly detailed environment and materials, high-quality character rendering, and the addition of ray-traced global illumination, which marks a significant leap over the standard indirect lighting. And last week, I asked you guys which game you would love to see covered on the channel first, this or Horizon Forbidden West, and most of you voted for Dragon's Dogma 2. And I was excited to cover this game, but my excitement was tempered by concerns over the reported performance issues on consoles. And unfortunately, now we know that these performance issues are not exclusive to the console version, as they extend to the PC version as well. And most of these issues come from the CPU performance of the game. And Capcom released a statement on Steam saying that a significant portion of the CPU load is allocated to NPC's physics, and this can cause performance issues in densely populated areas. And in these situations, changing graphics settings won't have a big impact on performance. And we don't need a big populated town or city to see this problem. Here at the starting area with some NPCs on screen, we can see that if I stand still or move slowly, the performance is fine. But as soon as I start moving quickly and turning the camera, the game runs significantly worse with low GPU usage and bad frame times. And this issue occurs in any populated area, even small settlement like this one. Now, when it comes to the graphics menu, the game does offer some good options here, but given how CPU intensive this game is, most settings won't affect the performance that much. The only one which does seem to make a difference is shadow quality. Like here for example, we can see that going from low to mid costs around 4%, to high 7%, and to max a massive 27%. So right now, I recommend avoiding Dragon's Dogma 2. Don't buy it and wait for more patches and updates. But if you want to play this game now, first make sure you have a CPU that can handle it, and try lowering the shadow quality to high or mid. And try capping the frame rates to 30 or 60 FPS using your GPU control panel or RTSS, which should make the frame rate and frame time spikes less severe and less noticeable. DLSS and FSR can also help a little during GPU bounce scenarios. However, the implementation here is not great. They both offer slightly superior anti-aliasing even compared to native TAA, but they look softer and blurrier as you can see here. That's why if you are going to use DLSS or FSR, I recommend applying some form of sharpening to improve the clarity of the image. And if you have an RTX 40 series GPU, try this mod by Pure Dark, which enabled the hidden DLSS frame generation, and that can help make the game feel smoother. So this is everything I can say about Dragon's Dogma 2 now. The game is heavily CPU limited, and to be honest, I'm not sure if Capcom will fix it. Because according to that statement, it seems like the CPU issues are tied to a core design of the game. And NPCs, pawns, and their AI is what makes Dragon's Dogma 2 special. And it's likely that completely resolving these CPU performance issues will take considerable amount of time, if it's even feasible. And I will keep an eye on this game performance progress, much like what I did before with The Last of Us Part 1 and Star Wars Jedi Survivor. And hopefully when the game performance is fixed, I'll make a proper optimization guide video. And until then, thank you so much for watching and for your time. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like. If not, leave a dislike. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for future videos. And hopefully I'll see you all in the next one, which will be about Horizon Forbidden West. So look forward for that.